When it comes to maintaining a healthy diet, what you eat can be an equally important factor when compared to how much. With so many different variables to keep in mind when designing your ideal diet, it's essential to keep an eye on the ingredients list on your food's packaging in order to determine exactly what's going on to your plate. Case in point, researchers have recently discovered that propionate, a common additive found in many processed and manufactured foods, may potentially be associated with obesity, as well as an increased risk of diabetes. But just how well-founded are these claims? Today, Bestie's going to unpack the research currently being conducted on propionate to determine just how much of a health risk this additive really is. Before we start, be sure to subscribe to Bestie and ring the notification bell in order to stay up to date on all of our daily videos and content. Propionate is a naturally occurring fatty acid, often added to certain foods in order to preserve freshness, extend the food's shelf life, and prevent the outbreak of mold. Propionate can commonly be found in foods such as baked goods, dairy products, processed meats, vinegar, sports drinks, and beer, just to name a few. According to researchers at Harvard University in Boston, the reason that this additive may pose a threat to one's health is because it could potentially disrupt the body's endocrine system. In a statement released regarding research into the additive, study author and Harvard professor of genetics and metabolism Gokhan S. Hatemislegil had this to say: "Understanding how ingredients in food affect the body's metabolism at the molecular and cellular level could help us develop simple but effective measures to tackle the dual epidemics of obesity and diabetes." In the first initial phase in the study on the effects of the additive propionate, researchers began using mice as test subjects. Right away, it was discovered that the additive appeared to have an immediate effect on the subject's sympathetic nervous system. This system plays an important role in a number of the body's automatic functions, such as heart rate. Specifically, propionate was noted as causing the test subject's sympathetic nervous system to suddenly become much more active. This, in turn, led to a surge of increased hormone production, which caused the animal's blood sugar levels to spike dramatically. It's worth mentioning that these kinds of blood sugar spikes are commonly associated with an increased risk of diabetes. When the mice used as test subjects were subjected to regular doses of the additive that were proportionally comparable to the doses of propionate a human might consume on a regular basis, the mice began to develop an increase in insulin resistance, otherwise known as prediabetes. Additionally, the mice began to gain weight as well, resulting in evidence that there might be an association between the additive propionate and the onset of chronic diabetes. According to the researchers in this study, these findings would seem to suggest that this particular additive is indeed an endocrine disruptor. What does that mean, you may ask? In an interview with health and nutrition website Healthline, endocrinologist Dr. Mansoor E. Shamali explained the situation thusly: "Endocrine disruptors are chemicals that are usually produced for commercial purposes that accidentally interfere with the normal functions of hormones. This can contribute to a wide array of health conditions because hormones play such an important role in the body." After developing an inkling of understanding on the effects of this additive in animal-based studies, the next logical step was to determine whether or not the additive propionate regularly demonstrated the same effects in human beings. For the second phase of this study on propionate's effect on our health, the researchers designed a double-blind study with a placebo control and 14 willing participants. Half of the study's human participants regularly ate food containing a full gram of propionate additive, while the other half were unknowingly given a placebo instead. Sure enough, the people who were given the additive with their food began to demonstrate hormone surges just like the ones researchers had observed when testing on mice. As a result, the researchers in the study were therefore able to draw the conclusion that the propionate additive was indeed equally hazardous to humans as it was to animals in terms of increasing the risk of developing obesity or diabetes. In the aforementioned Healthline study, Dr. Shamali weighed in on the results of these human subjects by saying, "Obesity and diabetes are complicated conditions that are due to genetic, environmental, and behavioral factors. The incidence of obesity and diabetes has grown dramatically over the past two decades. Since the human gene pool has not changed during that time, researchers are looking for environmental factors. However, While you or I might take a look at these results and deduce that the writing's already firmly on the wall, not all experts remain convinced that we can draw any concrete conclusions from the results of this particular study. One such skeptic is Dr. Charles Dinnerston, MBA, FACS, and Senior Medical Fellow at the American Council of Science and Health. According to Dr. Dinnerstein, it's such a small sample size that you can't really draw any meaningful conclusions. Propionate likely does alter human metabolism, but it's not a disruptor. It's like anything else we ingest. It just changes our metabolic profile. So we've taken a look at the research, gathered the results, and drawn our conclusions based on the findings. With all that out of the way, the question remains, where do we go from here? Well, at this point, it's probably worth mentioning that this isn't the first endocrine disrupting chemical found in our products. And in many cases, these ingredients are often banned after the negative impact they have on our overall health is brought to light. For example, bisphenol A is a chemical used for plastics and food packaging that was discovered to have endocrine disrupting properties, much like propionate. The plastic was commonly used in things such as baby bottles and sippy cups, but after this discovery was made, the chemical was banned shortly after. Another hazardous chemical is diethylstilbestrol, otherwise known by the much easier to pronounce moniker of DES. DES was originally used to treat women with high-risk pregnancies until being banned in the 1970s. In addition to causing endocrine disruptions linked to high blood sugar, obesity, and diabetes, the DES drug was found to also increase the risk of certain types of cancer in the women who took the drug. Unfortunately, banning a substance or additive in the United States isn't always as easy as a simple striking of its name on a list. Due to a loophole in the FDA's Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act of 1958, additives that were commonly used prior to the act being put into full effect are allowed to remain in circulation due to a grandfather clause. If you have any concerns regarding the presence of this additive in your food, a more viable short-term solution may simply be to pay closer attention to what your food contains on its ingredients list in order to make a more informed opinion when purchasing. So, where do you stand on the whole propionate debate? Do you agree with Dr. Shamali in that the effects of this additive are a cause for concern? Or do you side with Dr. Dinnerstein in the belief that the response to the additive and its side effects are a mere overreaction? Either way, we're always interested in hearing what our viewers have to say in regards to our topic, so be sure to let us know in the comment section below in order to help us keep the conversation going.
Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.